On September 18th, the Federal Reserve began their easing cycle with an initial 50 basis point cut to the Fed funds rate and an accompanying narrative that there would be more easing to come. Now, at the time, U.S. two-year Treasury yields were trading at a two-year low near 3.6%. Rates stayed low for the next week, but then the narrative changed quickly as better-than-expected economic data in the form of retail sales and labor numbers suggested that perhaps the economy wasn't slowing at all and that there still could be an inflationary resurgence lurking. U.S. two-year Treasury yields rallied aggressively up to a high of 4.26% on November 6th, just after the presidential election. Some analysts seem to believe that the election may be a tailwind for inflation, as evidenced by the spike in two-year break-even inflation expectations from 2.38% to 2.58%. Then came the November 7th FOMC meeting and the Fed's second ease, this time of 25 basis points. Now, going into the meeting, the CME FedWatch tool priced in the probability of a 25 basis point cut at over 95%. The question that many will ask is, does the Fed rate cut represent a genuine fear of a slowing economy, or does the chairman feel that rates are still in restrictive territory and will remain in that territory even after they cut? Or did the Fed feel that the market's consensus expectations were so aligned that not cutting may have disrupted markets? Now, the reaction in two-year Treasury yields was a modest gain post-ease from 4.20% to 4.22%. Now, if a trader believes that two-year yields could continue rallying, they could buy the November two-year Treasury yield futures contract at 4.20% and target a move to the psychological level of 4.75%. A stop for this trade could be placed below at 3.90%. This trade can make $550 if the target is reached and risks $300 if you're stopped out of your level. Now, if a trader believes that yields will fall from here, they could express that by selling the November two-year Treasury yield futures contract at 4.20% and targeting a move back to the September lows of 3.60. A stop for this trade could be placed above at 4.65. Now, this trade can make $600 if the target is reached and risks $450 if you're stopped out of your level.